In this talk, I will talk about the equations with absorption nonlinearity and with measured data, and then elliptic problem with the Hardy operators. Secondly, we will show the isolated singular solution of Hardy problem, and then I will show the semilinear Hardy.
Oui. I think we have lost the connection, no?
Aha. Probably with his line.
Yes,
internet connection.
We lost him, no?
Yeah, we lost him. I think so. Just all the people I still can see, but I cannot see him. So maybe there is a problem with the connection there.
Yes.
We can wait a little bit. Hopefully, he can come back. Yeah.
Don't worry, this is natural.
Yeah, that happened yesterday, and just after a moment, he came back. So hopefully today he can come back soon.
Yeah, we have got.
Now it's okay.
Now it's okay. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Yeah.
Oh, I'm not on page six. Not page six. I think we have to go to page two. One,
he must
two,
start
three.
Again.
I think.
It's okay.
Yes, but not.
Yes, I was begin from the very beginning. Is what Diaz told you.
Okay. Mm. Yeah. Just let me go back to the first page. Yeah.
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, here. So let me go to the full screen.
We cannot see it.
Okay.
So can you flash it again?
Yeah, I wish.
C'est la page 5.
Page 5. Okay. We have to go to page 3.
Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good.
Yeah. Here. Yeah. Let us start the at the first in this page. Okay. The same linear elliptic problem with the L1 source here, with L1 source. Then the absorption nonlinearity with the power p could be any p bigger than 1. And then this problem has a unique solution. In 1977, Leib and Simon considered the Thomas Fermi equation 1.2. And here also, there is the absorption nonlinearity with the power 3 over 2. But the source here is a Dirac mass. So here they considered this problem by variational method. And here, this is the L1 source, but here is a Dirac mass, it's a Lado measure. So one natural question is, what is the difference between the equation with the L1 source and the Lado measure? So, Professor Bridges answered this question, and they showed that when p is bigger than n over n minus 2, then the problem had no solution with the Dirac mass here. In 1980, British and Behum also considered the problem in the classical sense and in domain, except some the origin point. Then this problem has no zero, has only zero non-negative solution when P is supercritical. Here, we sometimes we call this is a saline exponent. Later, Behum gave a full classification for the subcritical case. In the subcritical case, that is P bigger than one, less than or n minus one, n minus two, then all the positive solution behaves at zero, either behaves like the fundamental solution or behaves like the with the x to the power minus two over p minus one. And also this we call this strong singularity. And the weak singularity, of course, this is the solution of 1.4 with the k here, with the k here. So the solution and the strong singularity could be the limit of k goes to infinity. For the non-positive solution, yeah, of course here, p is less n plus one over n minus one, then the solution could be has the same singularity like this. So in this case, this could be classified by some function, by some solution of the equation on sphere. So this is more complicated singularity here. With the Lotto measure, the Behum had a beautiful book in 2004 and showed that with the Lotto measure, with Lotto measure and the absorption nonlinearity, the problem has a unique distributional solution when nu is a bounded Lotto measure and g is a long decreasing locally Lipschitz continuous. And the satisfies, satisfies the integral subcritical assumption with the critical exponent n over n minus two. When n equal to two, then the basket involves the some giving some value beta depend on g. Of course, then for the measure with the Dirac mass or with the Lebesgue decomposition, and then this constant alpha j should be confined in this condition. Then the problem has a unique weak solution. In the supercritical case, of course, with the Lotto measure should be with absolutely continuous with respect to the Bessel capacity. Now, let's recall the Hardy inequalities. Hardy operator is from the Hardy inequalities. Here is the best constant when zero inside of the domain. This domain could be Rn. And then there are some improved Hardy inequalities with the square with some term like this or other term with the power p or bigger than two. Okay, if now we denote mu zero is a minus n minus two over squared over four, we will consider the when mu is bigger or equal to mu zero. So we defined the Hardy operator in this way. In this way, so this Hardy operator has only one singular point at the origin. By the ODE method, we calculate directly. We can get two solutions. One is phi mu. We can write it in this way. The other is gamma mu in this way. This phi mu has a stronger singularity than gamma mu. Here, the exponent, we can calculate like in this way, in this way. So here, mu is big or equal to mu zero. So this, I think here is some, let me see, here maybe some mistake here. So we have the, these two values are the 0 points of the equation. We calculated that directly by the homogeneous functions. And later we will use the tau minus, tau plus here. We omit the tau minus of mu, we always omit this part. Let me record some results with the of the semilinear Hardy problem. Dupin in 2002 considered the problem 1.13, and he involves three definitions of solution. One is of course classic solution, but here the classic solution is is less or equal to some constant of gamma mu, and then it's a H1 solution. Another is a distribution solution. And he showed with this constraint, then this problem, the three definitions are equivalent. And he showed the existence of a solution. For n bigger equal to three, mu is from mu zero to zero. And then here f is smooth, bounded and non-negative function. And defined a new critical exponent. When p is bigger than one, less or less than this critical exponent, then for they exist the t zero, and then they found a minimal class solution for t less t zero, and had a minimal distribution solution for t equal to t zero. And for t bigger than t zero, problem has no distribution solution. So here gives a the classification almost of the solutions. And for t equal to zero, this means the problem of here without this source. This is Brzezinski, Dupin, and Tse in 2005 showed that there exists a non-negative, non-trivial solution for p is less than this q, this critical exponent. The interesting point here is for the non-existence, of course, for p here, for p is bigger or equal to q star mu, this, there's no non-negative distribution solution. Of course, this is a very interesting point here, because this for mu is less than zero. This, this is only for this part. In 1991, Gwen and Behom showed the isolated singular solution of a Hardy problem with absorption nonlinearity. And the assumption for the mu bigger than mu zero is the integral subcritical assumption. And here is the critical exponent. Here is a critical exponent. This critical exponent is the Selene exponent when mu equal to zero. And mu equal to mu zero, of course, here the assumption also is in some assumption with because when mu equal to mu zero, the fundamental solution is behaviors like we can see, go back to here. Here. When mu equal to mu zero, this is exactly, this is, I think, is minus here. So this will equal to this. So both are equal to minus n minus 2 over 2. So here, then the critical exponent is n plus 2, n minus 2 over n plus 2. And so this is the critical exponent. And then this problem has for the key satisfy this, then has solution. For most singularity estimates has been done in by Gridea in 2014. He wrote a book about the semilinear Hardy problem with the absorption nonlinearity. Also, there are a lot of about the singular solution with some bounded Hardy potential, like the talk yesterday by Marcus, and and here we can mention that some interesting papers in Gigas and Beihong in analysis nonlinear analysis. Also here Tai and I mentioned before. Of course, there are many papers here. Now we go back to our problem. When mu equal to zero, phi mu zero is the fundamental. This is the Laplacian operator. Then the fundamental solution is x to the power 2 minus m, and in this case gamma mu is equal to 1. In this case, this is satisfies the fundamental solution with the distribution identity. So this distribution identity could be extended for mu from mu zero to zero, because this satisfies this. But here it's always zero. So it seems the Dirac mask cannot used to show this is a fundamental solution. This is fundamental solution cannot be seen by the Dirac mask. Especially when mu positive large, because this will be very singular, very singular. So in this case, this will not be good because it's not integrable at zero. Then, so this distributional identity is not suitable to deal with the Hardy problem. Now we use the two branches of functions phi mu and gamma mu, because this satisfies this and satisfies the equation. And then we compare together to both. We use both to calculate. And we can show that. This satisfies a new distribution identity. Here, the gamma mu is the gamma mu is here, capital gamma mu dx. And this gamma mu is like a base. And then the dual operator in this case is no longer L mu, no longer the same Hardy operator. And we can see here, of course, here has some, the power is 2 here, but we have x here. So this is has some singular at the origin, but not so strong. Not so strong because the order is 1, because that we can consider some parts here. So we calculate directly here. We can calculate because of this equality. We can calculate directly, use this as a test function, and then of course we can calculate directly in Rn over some small ball, and like R goes to 0. Then we can get the identity. So in this case, we can say phi mu is a fundamental solution. Phi mu is a fundamental solution. And when mu equal to zero, we can this equal to minus Laplacian. So this coincides our normal distribution identity. For the bounded domain, we can also use the gamma mu as a base, so we can get the distribution identity. We can get a fundamental solution here, but this the measure here, the gamma mu doesn't change. And the, also the dual operator is the same as before. Now let's go quickly about the, some proof. For of course, for the fundamentally unbounded domain, we can get a sequence and then we calculate directly and show this converge. For the non-homogeneous problem, we consider the problem L mu equal to F, U equal to zero. So we want to get the what the optimal condition for the F. There exists a solution. There exists a solution. When mu is bigger or equal to mu zero, F is, of course, here. F is a function in C set. And here, of course, could be singular at zero. Then we have the assumption here, and then problem, this problem with the subject has a unique solution. And this unique solution with the K, given K, we can have a solution, satisfy this, and then satisfy this distribution identity. Of course, this is for existence. For non-existence, if F is not EL1, d gamma mu, then we can get this no positive solution, when F is a EL1 in this case, and given U in of satisfies the class solution satisfies 2.8, then there exists the K positive, non-negative. Then this satisfies the identity with some K non-negative. The proof is first we show there exists solution for the when F has no singular at the origin, it's a CCD in the closure of omega. And then we show and the, we find the solution without with the weaker singular than phi mu. So in this case, we can get our distribution solution and the and this is the critical point. And then we use the test function of gamma mu. You, here we can get this identity. For mu, here we say for mu bigger than mu zero, we can use the super and the sub solutions. For mu equal to mu zero, a little more complicated for construct the super and the sub solution. And then for the dominant monotonicity converge theorem, we can get the take this the unique solution, for the non-existence, exactly. If we if F is not in this space, we can get a we can take a small, very small domain, a ball, small ball, and then we can get this will converge. This gets to equal to n, and then we can use the new function as a to compare, and we can get some estimates like here, and then we can get some value n depend on n, but the other part is not depend on n. And when n goes to infinity, we can get this non-existence, So here we just go very quickly about this. Okay, also with, I want to mention some mu less than mu zero, In this case, we can say there's no non-trivial, non-negative solution for F is a non-negative function. And the proof is very simple. Just we L mu, we take out some part of mu because mu is less than mu zero. We can get some get out of some hard parts. If F is non-trivial, then you if there is a solution, then this part will be not in L1 d gamma mu. So we can use the non-existence before, get here the non-existence. Now we take a look at the semilinear problem with measure. Because of the L, the Hardy potential, we want to give some Lardo measure depends on the Hardy potential. So we will use this the new distribution identity to set a distributional framework, and in this work we get the existence of solution, weak solution. So first we involve the Lardo measure space. The Lardo measure space here, of course, this is in omega star. Omega star is omega over 0. And in this domain, we can define the use this norm. If this, we can say this is a norm for the Lardo space. And then, of course, this we can use another definition. Could be as a natural extension for another space. So then, similarly definition of here, but this is important. And we define the space of M bar. M bar could be divided. Y is in omega star, and at 0, we plus the Dirac mass. But this Dirac mass is in the new sense of we can see later here. And the text function space, we will see here, because this has some singularity. The dual operator has a singularity, but not so strong. So we need this well in L infinity. So exactly, we can show this is the C011 space is a subset sub space of X mu. So this test function space is big enough for us, because here and this is very useful for us. So now we say if U is a weak solution of 3.1 here, 3.1, if satisfies the identity here, and for U is in L1 and GU is in L1, this low is the function to the boundary, and here L1 but with the potential here d gamma mu with potential, some potential here, nu is has the decomposition like in 3.4, and then in this case we have two parts. One part is the part up here. Another part is the Dirac mass is here. So there's some remarks about this the space. Zero is not the Dirac mass is not in this space, and but it could be a limit of this space, because we had the decomposition of the measure, so we need the absorption for the nonlinearity G as the following. The G is satisfying this. This we call the weak delta 2 condition. And then the K is here, the capital K depend on T. But if K is not depend on T, is a constant, then we can say this is the delta 2 condition. We involve the, recall the critical exponent here, P plus mu equal to 1 minus 2 over tau minus. So in this case, this is a NOM minus 2. So if mu is bigger than, is positive, this is less than this. But mu is less than this is negative, we have this is bigger than the selling exponent. Now let's see the this is Kato's type inequality. When we say the mu is in L1 become mu, L1 become mu, then we have the Kato inequalities like here, you in the test for the, any test function in the x mu omega. And we have the estimate L1 estimate in here. In for obtain this estimate, we need some show some special test function because the here has some singularity potential here, singular potential. So now let's see the existence. Now give a new is in the space, in the non-negative measures in this space. And the G is a continuous, this satisfies this condition, and satisfies weak delta two condition, and satisfies this subcritical integral assumption. But the critical exponent will be, it's the minimal P mu plus star mu and P zero. This is N over N minus two. This means we have the mu because the mu has the decomposition, decomposition this and this. So exactly mu star here and here has to correspond to both parts. Here we have some for when the new just like the mass, then P is less than P star mu in this case. And when only has K equal to, when we have K equal to zero, this means we don't have the Dirac mass at zero, then P could be less P zero star. Yeah, other case. If not, then we have this is optimal. So, but we see here before, here P star mu is less when mu is positive, but also this could be bigger than P star zero when mu is negative. One example is that we give a direction E1, and then we can construct a sequence point Dirac mass, and also zero point of here. We can say here the Hardy potential, the space you can see here. This new in this space, so we get respond to the coefficient an satisfies this. And this k is positive, then it will require the p less than p star mu. Okay, this is the example. When n bigger equal to 3 and the mu equal to mu 0, this is a critical Hardy problem. Then we have the singular critical exponent is n over n minus two. And then if just the Dirac mass, then we have the assumption here, and this is a critical exponent. And here, of course, this critical event, but with the loin part here. Here is not depend. This is equivalent to the assumption it's the same as Quoc-Hung's result, because this is equivalent, but this not depend on the K. Here is the example. Okay, for the supercritical case, we can say some this is a has a solution, then we can say this is a good, it's a GP good measure for new. And then we can see that for the if we just consider the outside part, then this if this is a absolute continuous with respect to the C2P prime, the Bessel capacity, then this is G good. Also, for the removable singularity, or depend on G. Yeah, if we say this is a capacity, also this depend the capacity. We have some results on this. Okay. Here we can go past the proof, some main idea. And first is the, we have to show the linear case. Of course, for example, the cutoff inequality, and because we want to get a sequence to convert to the measure. So one method is to use the monotonicity, and another is we have to prove the converge in the related space. Okay. So here we have to, if we prove the convergence, we have to use some very special test functions. These test functions we can let us to get a uniform estimate in L1 with this potential x to the minus one. Okay. For the isolated singular solutions, we can show the P mu, because here is just Dirac mass, then we can show this is this assumption will be equivalent. We can say proof, the proof is, we can say this beta, this, I mean, the K is not here, but because this critical case, mu equal to mu zero, but the K is not in the assumption. So we show the equivalence with the assumption, because this is a proof. Yeah, proof, this is equivalent, this is critical. In the domain omega star, we prove some solution of here. Prove the existence with existence. Of course, here in this case, when n equal to 2, this the coefficient of Dirac mass could be very important constraint to these values, between these values. And then for the we can consider the problem in the domain, except some small ball, and use the monotonicity, we can get the existence. And if this is a sand measure, we can we can put fixed one part, and then we take the limit and then take another limit. Okay, and we pass this fast. For the supercritical case, we have to consider the reduced measure. This is also considered by Bongzi in the paper, involved the reduced measure. And here also we can get the reduced measure. Yeah, of course, if mu star equal to mu, we can say this is the when G good, but when this is truncated, this non-linearity, of course, this should be equal because this is bounded. Also, the proof of this proposition is similar to the proposition 4.1 of Bidard, Behong, and Behong's in 1991, the paper. Of course, more properties for the reduced measures, like here. And the final part that we just mentioned a bit here is about when the singular point is on the boundary. If in the half space, we can get the best constant exactly is n squared over 4. Then calculate this directly, the L mu harmonic functions once on the boundary satisfies have the explicitly formula here. And then the exponent could be calculated directly here, like this way. And in this case, we can use the idea before. We can calculate use this as a gamma, this gamma mu, and with the multiply the test function, then together as a test function, we can get a new distribution identity here. Satisfies like this. We can get this is the fundamental solution. This is the fundamental solution on the boundary, but in the boundary case, in the boundary Dirac mass. With the boundary mass here. When we consider bounded domain and zero on the boundary, then this will be different as before, because in this case, this base, we use this as a base, but this will be different. Will different because the domain omega is not half. Not as the same as before, and so we need to find a new function as plays the same rule of the gamma mu. To this end, we consider the first eigenvalue function of this of the inequality, so we can get the for mu, and we can do a lot. And before this, of course, we have to say what the kind of domain has the first eigenvalue functions. So this is a Bridges basket involves this assumption. It's zero on the boundary and satisfies this estimate near when x is near the zero. In this case, first eigenvalue is achieved by some function, and this function we will use as test play the rule of here the gamma mu. So to this end, we will involve two space. One is H zero, another is depend on mu one. But this space is bigger than H zero one. So we always say mu bigger than mu zero, use the H zero one. And when mu equal to zero, we have mu one. So we denote this H mu. Then we have this problem has the first eigenvalue function. And then we can get an estimate. This estimate, we will see here, alpha plus, this is the we have calculated before. And the estimate for the gradient. And then we have the result. When mu is bigger than mu one, and we have the following classification. Yeah, if u is non-negative L mu harmonic, then there exists some k. Yeah, we have this, and here, when mu equal to mu one, because this is loin, and this is exactly it's the fundamental solution behaviors. Like. Okay. For the existence, because here is the classification, then we have to show they exist the solution like in this way. So we use this the condition C1, but here before for the classification, we don't need the assumption of this one. But for the existence, because we need that one for construct a solution. then if mu is mu bigger than mu one, we have this we can have a solution like this one, because this, similarly this is k equal to one here, and for mu equal to mu zero, this is the exact, this is the fundamental solution. Yeah. Of course, solution satisfies this here with the k equal to one here, and the test function space we choose. Also here it's a little different before, because this here with zero on the boundary. And this is some remarks about the measure. Yeah, we define some measure like this in this way, and then we can get the existence. We can get the existence. We can get the non-homogeneous problem with the, also like before, we divide the two parts. One is Dirac mass and another is the Lagrange measure. Oh, but here, because they're also inside omega we get some mu, we can get the existence. And here is a L mu harmonic. This is some special case of above. I think I stop here. Thank you very much. Happy birthday.